Today was supposed to be a Meat Boy day. We were supposed to cook up some short ribs, have a little bit of fun, but there might not be any more meat, and I certainly wasn't planning on talking about cell towers. You know, we were, again, going to say that they're taking our meat away, claim that these big meat companies are using fear-mongering to get people to buy cheap feedlot meat, and I still think that's a possibility. You know, we know there is no supply shortage of animals. Farmers are literally culling their herds. And there's no excuse to shut down meat plants if we're still allowing supermarkets, you know, fruit and vegetable processors to operate. There's no logic in that. If anything, more people are handling produce in a less sanitary environment than we are slaughtering and processing our meat. When I was reading these articles, they said the workers were getting sick. And I know that this Toyota Corolla is not transmissible via human contact. You have to be injected, just like fairy boys inject each other with certain things, on a daily basis. But if these workers are getting sick, what is it from? I decided to look up the meat plants that were temporarily closing and see if there were any cell towers or antennas nearby. And I was hoping, to all that is good on this planet, that I wouldn't find what I dreaded. Unfortunately, all of this is not a coincidence. The food supply chain is also vulnerable to the disease itself, not just the shutdown. On Monday, Smithfield Foods, the world's largest pork processor, closed its Sioux Falls, South Dakota factory due to a Toyota Corolla outbreak, raising concerns about a shortage of pork and processed meat reaching consumers. So the Smithfield Foods factory in South Dakota is conveniently located just south of three cell antennas. Yeah, I would assume if your workers are getting blasted by three military weapons emitting dangerous levels of radio waves, they might get sick. The impacted plants include Cargill in Hazleton, JBS Beef in Souderton, CTI Foods Hamburger Grinding Plant in Kingdom of Prussia, and Empire Kosher Poultry Inc. in Mifflintown, Cargill Meat Solutions, Hazleton Township, Pennsylvania. Literally a cell antenna just north, right across the street. JBS Beef Plant, Souderton, Pennsylvania. Right between two cell antennas. JBS Beef Plant, Greeley, Colorado, just north of a cell antenna. CTI Foods, Kingdom of Prussia, Pennsylvania, cell tower just north of the facility. Empire Kosher, Mifflintown, Pennsylvania, three cell towers, again, just north of the processing plant. So what's going on? If you look at the cell tower spacing, it's impossible to say this wasn't planned. They specifically had to have installed these antennas near these plants. And I would be interested to see if these antennas were all from a similar company or if they were installed, you know, by the same contractor. There is no fucking way six different meat plants would be located so close to these towers, five out of six of them being directly on the towers. This is just another military attack using radio wave technology. It's the perfect weapon for an evil government. It's invisible under the disguise of a cell tower, something you need for your electronic devices. Just point it at someone, get them sick, blame it on a made-up Toyota Corolla car accident, and destroy whoever you want. I wouldn't be surprised if I've already been given a lethal dose of radiation. It really is an invisible weapon. In this case, I would bet everything they pointed those towers at those meat plants to stage this, 100%. The point is, these towers are military weaponry that can be used to target anything or anyone. If they don't want you, your business, or anything going on, you are going to get zapped by an invisible laser and they're gonna slap a Toyota Corolla tag on that body bag. Sad world, huh? They can do whatever they want. Every time I try to step away from the Wi-Fi tower stuff, it just relates back to these godforsaken devices. So we know what they did. They intentionally targeted these meat plants. Now, why did they do it? Why would you blitz the media with all of these articles? You know, dozens and dozens of news stories. Even my parents heard about this and they're, you know, the sheeple out in the field eating the grass. You know, I literally showed my hospital video to my father yesterday, and he was like, "Oh, they must need some joy because of all the death they're seeing." Yeah, were the soldiers in World War II dancing over in Germany? You know, why do they need to tell everyone that there's going to be a meat shortage? Is it more predictive programming, preparing you for grain-based slop, the slave diet? Do the nutrients in meat cure the illness? Do they strengthen your immune system to the point where you won't get some random illness so they can slap that Toyota Corolla tag on your coffin? Or is it a plot to get people to buy more cheap feedlot beef? You know, are other foods selling out of supermarkets, but they still have some meat on the shelves? Are the carnivores, ooh-wee, here to save you now that you can't get your trusty feedlot beef at your local grocery store? Yes, the US could face minor local food shortages, but they will be temporary.
Images of empty grocery store shelves, farmers dumping thousands of gallons of milk, and long lines at food banks have sparked fears this week of mass food shortages in the US. A prospect that experts say is extremely unlikely. Though due to the sudden disruption to normal distribution channels, consumers may see temporary, minor shortages on some food items as the food system adapts to changes.
Is this young lady psychic?
But they will be temporary.
You seem awfully confident, lady. As I said yesterday, line these pricks up in front of a ditch. They are all in on it and laughing in our stupid faces. Maybe she's not psychic. Maybe she's related to billionaire Barry Sternlicht. I don't know. Oh, look, he went to Harvard Business School. Is that where they teach you to steal other people's money? Okay, the food supply chain is vulnerable. So why are you guys only shutting down meat processors? What about all of the rats and animals that get into grain supplies, the dozens of farm workers and grocery store hands that touch produce, fruits, and vegetables? Aren't you a bunch of hypocrites for shutting down well-sanitized meat processing facilities, but still letting people shop in supermarkets? How are people allowed to go to the supermarket, purchase and eat food that dozens of hands have touched, yet you can't operate, you know, these meat processing plants where they literally spray chlorine and these sanitizing chemicals that will make you sick itself everywhere? Nothing makes sense. None of this makes any sense whatsoever from a sanitation perspective. If you really think about it, the cleanest food you could possibly eat is meat cut out of a freshly slaughtered animal. It's literally never touched anything else. Whereas these fruits, these vegetables are grown in soil, you know, they're touched by insects, bugs, all these things. It's not a comparison. Clean meat from a freshly slaughtered animal is the safest food you can eat. Will closing of meat processors create shortages at your grocery store? No, normally it wouldn't, but since you're plastering the news with these fear-mongering articles, you can bet your ass every idiot is going to go out and stock up their freezer with an unnecessary amount of poisonous feedlot meat, just like you've convinced everyone to stay locked in their homes like rats without having to make any laws. I mean, the carnivores, woo-wee, have been trying to shovel this shit down people's throats for the past few years. All we had to do was create more fake news. Ooh-wee! We have lots of meat in storage, said Potts, whose members represent 95% of the beef and pork production in the country and 70% of turkey production. We have plenty of plants that are still operating as normal across the country. The National Chicken Council in Washington, D.C. also issued a release saying that almost all plants are in operation. Those social distancing requirements are slowing down some chicken processing lines.
Fortunately, we're not experiencing any plants closing at this time, the release states. Our top priorities right now are keeping workers safe and keeping chicken flowing on store shelves. In that order.
Stores may not be receiving the same variety of products, Randall said, but volumes are still large, and Alliance members have a lot of meat and poultry in storage. So we know the farmers have plenty of animals, that there is an abundance of meat stored up. The problem seems to be more with the demand than the supply, with all of the restaurants closed, with the elite people literally destroying the middle class, completely decimating any small business's livelihood, there is a sudden excess of specific cuts of meat that were only used in restaurant service. You know, the average American isn't going to be buying bacon and sausage by the case or whole beef briskets. You know, there's an idea that meat is bad for you, but when people go out, you know, they tend to eat more meat as opposed to at home. These feedlot farmers are sitting on warehouses full of meat and are staging a shortage in the news because they know they are fucked. They are completely screwed and are going to be out a lot of money if they don't create this fake panic in the media. And they probably view this as a good thing if they're lying, because they're not wasting food if people take it. You think they could tell the truth for once? Howdy, boss! We're gonna lose a bunch of money on this poisonous meat if y'all don't start sucking it down like a fairy boy in Hell's Kitchen at 3 a.m. on a Saturday night. Ooh-wee! thank you guys for joining me today. Hopefully, this incentivizes people to do something about this, and they realize that nothing's gonna happen when you sit at home. You know, go hand out some flyers, go speak to some people, whatever it may be. You know, we need to start doing something to get our lives back. So if you guys do want to support me further, please check out all the stuff down in the description below. We will be doing a workout live stream today at 2 p.m. Eastern time. If you guys would like to join us, you know, just check out my workout, answer a few questions here and there. So you guys enjoy the rest of your night.